welcome to Knit Night with Mika Mika. My name is Shamika Clark, and I am going to take you on my journey to Edinburgh Yarn Festival. This is episode 6, Edinburgh Yarn Festival Hangover Part 1. Because there will be 3 parts, because there is just so much that I want to tell you about, so much information I have, and so much footage that it all can't fit into one. So, let's begin. You can find me all over social media. My Instagram is Mika Mika Shop. My Etsy is Mika Mika. You can contact me via email at mikamikashop@gmail.com. I have a Ravelry group called Knit Night with Mika Mika, and you can find me as Shamika Knits on Ravelry. My YouTube channel is Mika Mika Shop, but you're here, so you already know that. So let's get started with the Edinburgh Yarn Festival craziness. Oh my goodness, I had so much fun. So, before we even get to Edinburgh, let's talk about what happened in New York before I left. I need a sip of water before I get started, because this is a lot of stuff. Like, it's just ice water with lemon. Excuse me. So we set out for Edinburgh on Wednesday night. Now, before we did, I met up with Grace from Babbles Traveling Yarns. She was in New York for a few days. So on Tuesday night, we met up and she was at Pearl Soho. And I met her there. We took the train to Brooklyn General. She bought some yarn. I was trying to hold back. And then after Brooklyn General, we went to Woolen and we had Knit Night there, and she was very welcomed during the Knit Night. And we still bought yarn. She actually brought me some yarn from Isis Fiber Arts in, where was she staying? She was in Vancouver? Yes, I think. Well, Canada. So she purchased yarn and brought it for me. Or actually, I purchased the yarn and she brought it for me. So that was really special. So I will show the yarn later, but I just wanted to give a little preface to our journey. So the day of, which was Wednesday, was the day we were flying. She came to my house and she was in the kitchen. My mom's cooking and she's just talking and knitting and just enjoying quiet time to knit. And I was frantic, going crazy, trying to get everything situated, fit everything in the suitcase, make sure I didn't overpack because I wanted to make sure I had space to bring things back because I knew I was gonna go yarn crazy. Trying to make sure I had all my photography equipment, trying to make sure, just everything. So finally I got it all together with about 15 minutes to spare, scarfed down some curry chicken and some curry vegetables. My mom cooked curry for Grace. Grace is vegetarian, so she made pumpkin, chana, aloo, which is chickpeas and potato, as well as bodhi. We call it bodhi, but it's string beans, and bhaji, which is spinach. So we made all of that. My mom's cooking all this while I'm running around frantic, trying to, you know, get everything in the suitcases and whatever. So anyway, so we did that and we left and we went to the airport. We met up with my friend Cece, who's Creative Cece on Instagram, Ravelry. And we met up with her friend Shantae. Now, Cecilia is an avid knitter. We've been knitting together. I think we've known each other like at least 9 years. So we are always, you know, doing different things, going to different knitting events and the like. Shantae is a brand new knitter. So she was basically starting out a cowl that day. She knows how to knit in purl, so we were getting her into it. She's also very much the planner person, and she likes to make stationery and buttons and all those little crafty things. So this was going to be a great trip for her as well. And we just wanted to explore Edinburgh in general. So we were just really, really, really excited about our trip. So we had a glass of wine and then we boarded the plane. Get to the plane. Who do I see getting on the plane? Kristen Vollenvine. I'm like, hey, Kristen. So it was pretty cool because we had like at least 5 knitters on the plane. I'm sure there was some hiding, but I didn't see everybody, but this was just awesome. So what we did is we took a plane into Dublin and then we took another shorter flight into Edinburgh. So we did that. we get to Edinburgh and we got there on the Thursday morning or afternoon-ish. So that night was the knit night at Akva. Excuse me. So we chilled out for a minute in the hotel room. I started making plans as to what I want to buy and this and that. And then we went to Akva and it was amazing. I have not seen so many. I think there must have been at least 200 knitters in that place. We took over the whole place. They weren't ready for us. They really weren't. I mean, I ordered chips and it took forever. They just weren't ready for the multitude of people, I don't think. But the food was good. It was, you know, bar food. They had a special menu for us. They had specialty cocktails. I had a mojito made with rum from Trinidad. I didn't think I'd find Trinidadian rum in Scotland, but I did. And I was like, woohoo, I have to have it. What else happened? I met so many people. It was just like surreal because you see everyone on Instagram, and I do the VKNs, virtual knit nights, so I'm talking to people all around the world, and you build these relationships, and then you actually see them face to face. You can touch them, you can hug them. I gave like 10 million hugs that day, and I was just so happy to meet everybody. My smile was just not getting off my face. I was just like, it was just so exciting. So I sat around, I chatted with everyone, and we took pictures and videos, and you know, because we're all, a lot of us were podcasters, so of course we wanted to make sure we got some good footage, and I do have some good footage. Oh, I don't know if it's good. I'm gonna have footage, we'll see how it works out, but I will insert it in later on in the show. So, went to Akva, tired myself out, talking all night. And then we headed home and I had to get rest because I had to go to Edinburgh in the morning. So got up, ate breakfast in the hotel, and I'm looking at the time. I'm like, dang it, it's 9 o'clock. I should have been there already. So I was going to take the bus. The bus took 40 minutes from the hotel. And this was like my first time taking a bus. I didn't really know what was going on. So I was like, screw this. I got to take a cab. So I get in the cab in Edinburgh. There is Wi-Fi in the cabs, people. Like, what? New York needs to step its game up, for real. so, excuse me, I had a little cold previously, so it's like, eh. Anyway, I don't wanna be coughing all over the place. So, I get in the cab, I'm on Wi-Fi, I'm checking out stuff, and I see like a line for the queue on Instagram, and I'm just like, oh my gosh. So when I get there, I'm like looking at the line, and it's like, whoo, and I'm just like, wait a minute, I have a badge. So I show my badge to people at front, and they're like, oh, just go in. So excited. So this was at like maybe 9:40 that I may have stepped in. So I walk in and it's quiet. And you know, I'm just like, wow, this is beautiful. You see all the beautiful yarn. And I had no idea what I wanted, but I was just like, let me just take a quick walk around and see, like get some footage and see like, you know, what the lay of the land is before I start going crazy. That lasted all of 5 minutes because I saw La Bien-Aimée, sorry if I'm pronouncing it wrong. And I kind of went berserk immediately. So I didn't know what color I wanted. And the problem with me is when I don't know what color I wanted, when I don't know what color I want, it's because I want them all. So you'll see in the video how confused I was as to picking color, but I ended up picking some beautiful colors. And the reason I went ham there was because I don't have any set plans to go to Paris at the moment. I do want to go in the future. I don't know when it will happen. So this was like my once in a lifetime experience to get this yarn. I worked hard, saved my money. I knew it wasn't cheap, but I knew it was a luxury brand that I really, really, really wanted. So yeah, I went a little crazy, but you know, I earned it. So what can I say? So I went to La Bien-Aimée. After La Bien-Aimée, I was just walking around and I went to Java Pearl Designs. I met Cece Allman And what attracted me to her booth, I saw her pink hair and I was like, ooh, nice. And then I saw her sock. There was a sock book, a new sock book that she came out with. And you guys know I love making socks. I always have a sock on a needle. So I was very, very, very interested. So I started talking to her. I bought the book and I bought a bag that she had. And the whole book is a play on coffee. So I'm like, I can't live without coffee. So it was just like totally right up my alley. So I met her, we talked about the book, and she also offered to give away a copy of the book on the podcast. So once I do a formal book review, I will have the giveaway. This will come in a later episode, but I'm so happy that she offered that. That was really, really, really generous of her. And I can't wait to get into the book. So I also have some footage I will show you of me just being in her shop and having a little convo with her. So what else? After that, I kind of got a bit overwhelmed immediately because that's when a lot of people just showed up out of nowhere. And I got really hot and I was just like, oh my God, I need some ice water. It was just like insane the amount of people that came in, because it's like everyone who was on the queue lined up to get in at 10 o'clock just bum rushed the place. I couldn't get past. I had to like reach over people to look at yarn, and I was like, okay, I'm gonna step away and I'm gonna go just have a drink. So I go to step away and I bump into Eric Lutz from Sticks Plus Twine, and we ended up basically spending the rest of the day together. So we got something to eat, we found a table near where the podcast launch was, we sat down, we decompressed for a bit. He had already bought stuff, I had already bought stuff, we were comparing items, and then it just seemed like a flock of people were coming towards us, podcasters as well as viewers, and it was such a nice thing to be able to just sit and talk to people and actually get to know the people who have been watching me that I didn't even know, that made themselves known to me. Thank you so much. I gave everybody a hug. I don't remember everyone's name right now, and I tried to take as much pictures as I could, but I know I missed a few people and I'm really, really, really sorry. But I was really, really happy to meet you and to know that you enjoy the podcast and wherever you are in the world and it touches you. So I'm very, very excited about that. So after meeting all these people, in my mind, it's kind of a blur. It just kind of meshed into when we had the podcast lounge. So I met a ton of podcasters. I'm gonna go down the list pretty soon, but I'm just gonna jump fast forward to after that. I did one more circle around the marketplace, and that's when the color work bug started to bite. And I found the Jameson and Smith at Pearl Essence. Jameson and Smith was there, and there was a specific hat pattern that basically for like, I know I spent less than 15 pounds on all the yarn, and you could just do any color you want. Like, you know, it was just beautiful. So I'm gonna show you the pattern, I'm gonna show you the yarn, everything. But that was my last purchase for that day. Yeah. And then I left. And we went to the Kaylee on Friday night at the Gilly Do. Now what had happened is there was initially a Kaylee set up by the organizers of the Edinburgh Yarn Festival. And they're like, oh, 9 a.m. on Saturday morning, buy your tickets. And at 9:01, it was sold out. So we were like, what the heck just happened? So Grace, oh, I love her so much. She organized a Kaylee at the Gilly Do and basically sent a message around to a bunch of people on Instagram, and we ended up having this whole big WhatsApp group chat so that we could all talk about and coordinate getting money to her to pay for our slot and everything like that. And we had, I think, about 20 people, or 25, I can't even remember. We had just a really big table. The food was exquisite. I mean, it was just like, okay, so you walk in, you go upstairs, and then they have a big wide open space, and then they have all the tables set up, and they ask you as soon as you walk in the door if you wanted whiskey or did I have, was it Prosecco? It was either champagne or Prosecco. I know it was something bubbly. So you have that, you come in, you mingle, you talk to everyone on your table, and it was like the whole table. And all these knitters from all over the world and podcasters alike. So we got to really get to sit down and talk to everybody. And after that, we ate. I had a mackerel. It was like a pate, but it was made with mackerel with oat crackers. I've never had oat crackers before. I need the recipe. They're so good. And then I had a chicken stuffed with haggis. And that was delicious. That's the first time I had haggis in my life. And I know everyone's like, some people are on the fence about it, but I really, really love it. And then for dessert, it was Tipsy Laird. And I don't remember eating it because I ate it so fast. It was good. It was really good. And then I just had a glass of wine after. And then the fun started. There was a band playing. They started dancing, so I was dancing all over the place until I was like really hot, and I was just like, oh, I need a break, I need a glass of water. So we had so much fun, and then after that, go home, rest up for Edinburgh the next day. So round two of the Yarn Festival, I went back with a general idea of what I wanted, because after seeing some of my friends' purchases, I was like, oh, where'd you find that, or what stall was that in? Because remember, I was overwhelmed and I didn't get to go back and look again. So I went a second time and I looked and I realized that Justina Larkowska was there teaching, and I was wearing her sweater, her design, Fickle Heart, my pink sweater. So I was really looking for her because I wanted to get a picture with her. So I went to Martin's lab. Martin is her husband, who has beautiful sock yarn. And I get there, but she wasn't there. I guess she may have been teaching or something. So I said, oh, I'll come back and buy something. I ended up not, because I got caught up in another booth. And next thing you know, it's like, okay, money is really running out. So can't buy it all. And how was I going to fit it all in my suitcase? Oh my goodness. So, but what I did end up doing is I bought yarn from Garthener, which is a very rustic sheepy yarn, but it's so pretty. I bought that for my friend Mars, Hey Brownberry, because that's what she wanted. And I think it was she gave me a list of all the things she wanted, and it touched everything on the list, so that was perfect for her. So I want to get that out of the way. I took a video of their stall as well. And then I went to Easy Knits to get a glittery bright striping, self-striping yarn, sock yarn, because Carola had it. Carola from, what's the name of it? I'm going to get into all these people again, but Carola's podcast is What Makes My Soul Happy. So I saw her with it and I was like, ooh, where'd you get that? So I went and got that. I had went back to La Viera May because I had to buy more yarn, of course. You will see it all. And I also went, I'm looking over there because all the yarn's over there, so I'm trying to remember in chronological order, what did I do? The last place I went to was Loxton's, and they had yarn for £4, wholesale, undyed, beautifulness. So I'll explain my whole reasoning for buying and everything when I do the haul, but yeah, so I went back there and I purchased. And then we had the podcaster lounge again. I met more podcasters that I hadn't seen the day before. Got to hug everybody and take pictures and find them all on Instagram and all of that good stuff. And then Edinburgh Yarn Festival was over and I went home, well, to the hotel. But it didn't end there. that night, I don't know what we had for dinner. Or maybe we were walking around, or maybe I just crashed. But I know we had two more days in Edinburgh, so what I did is do the touristy things the next few days. And then after that, we took a flight to Dublin. So we had 4 days in Dublin, so we did more touristy things there. I found another yarn shop that actually had their yarn in Edinburgh, but somehow I missed it. But it's okay, I made up for it and I bought more yarn. I don't know how I was able to squeeze it into my carry-on, but I made it all to the US. It all got here And I just had fun in Dublin, flew back on St. Patrick's Day, and then I came home and I slept. Went to a party the next day. I saw, you know, a bunch of friends I haven't seen in forever. I felt really strange being back in New York and seeing all the familiar faces, because I was just used to like being like kind of anonymous in a new land. Even though I had my knitting / podcaster friends, it felt kind of good to be like, to really not know anybody and like just walk around and do whatever. And then I come back and I go to a party, it's like, hi. It's just a little overwhelming, but it's okay. Those are my friends. We had fun. We had a good time. So good of a time that the next day I was a little sick and I just had to drink water all day and eat crackers and sleep. So the jet lag caught up with me, and on top of that, I had wanted to record the day after, which was last Sunday, and I was coughing and had this whole nasty thing in my throat, and you guys don't need to be hearing that. So I was just trying to wait it out. I made a concoction of ginger, like you boil the ginger root with cinnamon, squeeze the lemon in it and put honey. And if you really want to make it a hot toddy, you just put a little rum or whiskey or whatever, it's whatever your flavor is. But I didn't put any alcohol. I just drank it like that. And lo and behold, I was able to talk the next day, and whatever nastiness that was in my throat, it was gone. So, aside from all this, I still had work to go to throughout the week. And, so, you know, it's like, I really want to stay home and sleep, but I can't because, you know, bills have to be paid. So, that is my quick synopsis of my trip. Okay, loudness going on in the kitchen. That is my quick synopsis of the trip. And I'm going to start now with showing you what the things that I have to show you from Edinburgh. So let's begin. So the first thing I have to display is my Blacker Yarns Knit Along shawl, Udale, from Yana Hook. And this shawl, it's lightweight, but it's really, really warm. I wore this just long enough to take pictures, and I was just like, oh my god, it's too hot, I gotta take it off. So I can wear it just, you know, regular shawl, the regular shawl way, just whatever. Or I use it as a scarf that day, and you just kind of just wrap it around like that, and it's fluffy and nice and beautiful. So I was happy with the yarn. What I wasn't happy with too much, well, it kind of just surprised me. When I went to block it, I soaked it as usual, because that's what you do, that's what you should do when you have wool. Excuse me. I soaked it, and there was so much dirt in the water. I had to wash it 3 times. This is nothing against Blacker Yarns. It's just that it is a sheep wool. It's not, you know, commercially manufactured or anything like that. This is like off the farm and onto your knitting needles. That's how I feel about it. So you most definitely have to wash it. There was sediment at the bottom of the basin when I washed it, and I washed it with soak because I have a bunch of samples from soak that I've accumulated over the years going to knitting festivals and stuff. So I washed it, and after the third rinse, everything came out. I rolled it up. I have yoga mat. I laid it across the yoga mat and was able to pin it out to my liking, and I am happy with it. It's a little itchy right now, but I think that with time and once I start like wearing it more, I'll either get used to it or whatever. And I really like it this way. more so like a scarf than a shawl. I'm really warm in it. And I think that, I think it's a good look. What I ended up doing is buying yarn to make a hat to go with it. I didn't want to use the leftover yarn because I wanted something a little bit softer. So I bought a different skein, a different blacker yarn, but because I already had a discount because I finished the thing, I was like, oh, might as well buy blacker yarn. And I found a color that matches this gray color here. So I was able to buy the yarn to make the hat. And what I'm gonna do is make the London Fog hat. And it's designed by Thea Coleman, I think. I have to double check that. I'll put the name at the bottom. But I'll insert a picture somewhere. Here, wherever. So that hat is going to be really nice, and hopefully I can find a cute little pom-pom to put on top. I like this fur pom-pom look. That'll be that. So this is my one FO for the festival, and I know I was really trying to get the sweater, the Glenfiddich sweater, done because it would have been so perfect because Glenfiddich is made in Scotland and I was in Scotland, and I knit a whole sleeve on the plane. But honestly, there comes a time where even me, who everyone, I know you guys are so like, you're happy that I can knit really fast, and but I got tired. I really got tired. You know, I'm not a machine. I'm human. There are days when I just speed along, and then there are days when I just need to take a break. And if I didn't sleep, I would not have had as fun of an experience at Edinburgh as I did. So I think it was a lot easier and better for me to just get some sleep, forfeit the sweater, work on it during my time there, and be able to, you know, just enjoy the actual festival and not be walking around like a zombie. It is enough that the adrenaline rush you get tires you out, and at the end you're just like, oh, you know. But that on top of being ridiculously tired because you're trying to finish with and making the knitting more stressful, I think that just wasn't in the cards for me. I just didn't want that. So the sweater is not fully completed, and I will show it to you now because it is in my whips. Okay, here is the sweater that I meant to complete for Edinburgh and didn't. This is the yarn, Madeline Tosh DK in the Tarte colorway. This is the sweater. Oh no, that's the inside part. This is the back of the sweater, and I'm actually going to put it on. The sleeve goes all the way. It fits perfectly. And oh, I'm getting this thing wrapped around me. The second sleeve. Okay. See if I can stand up a little bit so you can see it. So yeah, second sleeve is at the elbow. Once the sleeve is done, I have to pick up the neckline and button band and make a ribbed button band. I love how this sweater feels. I love the cable design. I love the way it looks on this yarn. I didn't alternate skeins, I just went straight, and I don't feel like there's any problems with color variation. It just, to me, it is perfect. So yeah, there you go. See if I can show you the back. Woo! So there you go. So it's almost there. You all know I'm in these knit alongs. So I want to enter this into the winter camp knit along, and in order to do so, I would have to finish it by the end of the month, which is Friday. We'll see if it happens. It's possible. It's just half of a sleeve and a neckline, so we shall see. So that is my Glenfiddich sweater that is still in progress. I'm very happy with it. I didn't meet my deadline, but I'm not mad at myself because I'm still happy with my sweater. And I'm wrapping up myself in this. Okay, here we go. So I will show my next whip is something I casted on when I went to Dublin. So while we were in Dublin, we had a day trip to Blarney and Cork. So we were on a bus for 3 hours each way, and then we had little stops here and there. So what I did is I didn't want to take that big heavy sweater on a bus. So when you travel, what's the best thing to travel with? A pair of socks. So these socks are the socks that I chose, and this is, let me try to get a little closer. This was designed, the designer is Madame Tricot, and she is also known as the Nappy Knitter, or Nappy Knitter, sorry, on Instagram, and it's the stripy sock. She specifically designed this in conjunction with La Bien-Aimée's sock duos. It's a BFL nylon mix, I think. I will let you know for sure when I do the haul, because then I can actually read the tag. So this is one of the colors that I bought. It's called, the purple is peanut butter and jelly, and the orangey part is tang. Like the juice, the juice mix that I grew up on. So I thought it was super cute. So this was my sock knitting. It started here the night before, and then I did this whole part on the trip. Heel flap was done on the plane home, and this is where I am now. I am almost ready for the toe, and I still have to knit another sock. This is actually part of Sockmatician's sock along. What does he call it? The Sockmatician sock KAL or something. I can't remember. I'll put it in a down bar. But it has to be done by the end of the month as well. And of course, I can double dip and put it into the winter camp knit along, and my box of socks knit along. And what's the other one that I'm doing? Brown Bag Sock Club. So this is great. So that is that. Aside from that, winter camp is going on right now, and this is the last installment of the snowball fight. I won the last one. Me and my team, I should say my team won the last one. And we also won the January one, because I can't say it's just me. I know I do knit fast, yes. But however, I have a life. I still go to work. I still have to stop and make dinner and stuff like that. So knitting throughout the whole day is not always an option for me. But I do have wonderful teammates. And when one person is sleeping, someone else is knitting. When one person's, you know, oh guys, I can't finish it up tonight. You know, I'm just gonna rest now and start again in the morning. Oh, it's okay. I can stay up for 3 more hours and keep knitting. So our last tally was about 200 pieces. And by pieces, I mean blanket square or blanket triangle or crochet hexagon or me with my hexi puffs. So I have my hexi puffs in here. I haven't even counted yet, but this is what I've done in the past 2 days. So I'll let you know by next week if how much I've fully completed and if I actually won again. It's just a great thing for us to come together and do this, and it's a lot of fun, and we love being competitive. This bag, actually, let me explain where I got it from. This I got in Edinburgh from Little Grey Girl. What happened is I passed by the booth and I was like, oh my God, my sweater is too big. I need a bag to put it in, because I had it in some like random Marshalls bag or something. And it needed a proper project bag. So I saw the pink hearts. I fell in love. And it was 18 pounds, and I felt that that was a good price, so I got it. And I really love this bag. It's handmade very well. And I have no problems with it. It sits up and then it squishes and you can put it somewhere and then you can just pull it out and your project is in here and it's clean and it's safe from the elements. And I have no complaints about it. So I'm happy with this. So, So I do want to get to my other haul purchases, stuff like that, because I know that's what you're waiting for. But I also want to acknowledge all the people that I've met, and because they've made my Edinburgh experience so much fun. So I'm just gonna go down the list. These are people who I've met along the way. I either met them at the Kaylee or I met them day one or day two. So I have to actually give Becky a shout out. Becky is from Stringing It Together podcast. She's also Soprano Knits on Instagram. So I met her and Hannah from the Corner of Craft together because they traveled together to Edinburgh and they just started talking to me and it was just like instant, oh my God, this is so cool. We're together, da 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 da. And then I was just like, by the end of the conversation, I invited them to New York. I'm like, anytime you're in New York, come, I'll take you around to all the yarn shops. We'll go for dinner. They're super duper duper sweet. So I looked at Katie's camera, Katie from Inside Number 23, and I was like, oh, that's so cool. You can flip your screen around. So I was doing a video. Does this work? Okay, so I have, I'm turning it on. I was doing a video with Hannah and I'm holding it like this, but obviously I can't see what's going on the other side of the screen. And she goes, you know, no, this is not Hannah, sorry, Becky, my apologies. So Becky goes, your thing looks like it can move. And I was like, what are you talking about? So she does this. Yeah. And all of a sudden, I can see what's in front of me as I'm podcasting into the camera. And I'm just like, how could I have been so dumb? This is how I could have been so dumb. I bought the camera and I didn't read the dang book that came with it. I got so excited and I was just like, I just want to take pictures. So I was going to play around with it. Didn't realize that this thing moved. Changed my life. So Becky, thank you so much. You have changed my life for the better. Anytime you come to New York, you better call me. We're hanging out, okay? So I'll continue with the list of people who I've met that I was very happy to hang out with. So aside from meeting Hannah from the Corner of Craft and Becky from the Stringing It Together podcast, I also ran into Charlotte from the Charlotte and Gus podcast. I met Charlotte virtually on a knit night, and I think it was when I was doing my sweater for Rhinebeck, and I was up one night sick, and I was just like, you know what, let me just get on the VKN. And I was up till like some ungodly hour of the morning, but in Paris, it was daytime, so she was talking, and we just hit it off. And when I actually saw her, I was like, oh my God. So it was so happy. I was so happy to see her and everything. Big hugs everywhere to everyone. I ran into Ellie from the Skein Dare podcast, and she has just changed my life because now I am stuck on wanting to make colorwork socks. She actually just released a colorwork pattern. And next podcast, I'm going to feature that, and I'm going to have a giveaway for that pattern as well. It's called Colors of the World, or Color Your World. I'm gonna put the name down here so you don't get confused. It's a beautiful sock. She's Norwegian, and I think Norwegians just are born knowing how to do color work. It's just out the womb, you just start knitting. So her color work is just absolutely genius. So she's really inspiring me, and you guys know that I love to do color work, and I had basically said I'm gonna give it a little break and do cables with my Glenfiddich sweater, but now the bug is really biting me again. So thank you so much, Ellie. So happy to have met you, happy to have you in my friend circle right now. We'll see if I can make it back to the UK to another knitting festival. Let's work on that. I was so happy to meet her. And I also met Carola, who is Amber Fox 84 from the What Makes My Soul Happy podcast. Carola was one of the people who initially contacted me when I said I was going to Edinburgh, and I was like, hey, if anyone wants to meet up. So she messaged me and I'm like, oh my God, I actually met her in person. Hugs nonstop. She is the sweetest person ever. And she's also getting started into the color work thing too. Between me, her, and Ellie, I think we bought out so much Jameson and Smith. It's ridiculous. it's just cool to have friends who do the same thing you do. It's just beautiful. And to know that we're all working on the same types of project and we can help each other out. And this is actually Carola's first color work project, so she has me and Ellie to guide her along the way, whether it's picking colors or, you know, how do you manage your floats or just anything like that. So I think that's pretty cool. I also met Anna from the Yarnesty podcast. She just did her first episode and I love it. She's actually from Sweden and I'm at the Kaylee and I see her and just big smiles, big hugs, and I'm like, I felt like I knew her from before. It was just this weird thing that you just take to someone. You just kind of just like, your souls are just connected somehow. It's just this weird thing. I don't know if it's just the knitting thing and everybody's happy and I don't know, but we just had so much fun. Of course, Grace from the Bobbles Traveling Yarns podcast. She's family now. That's just what it is. So yeah. Hi, Grace. I met Vero from Along the Lanes. I actually interviewed her, so their interview will be in here somewhere. Vero, when she did her Edinburgh recap from last year, that's actually, like, after 5 minutes, I was like, yep, I'm going to Edinburgh. That's it. Nothing's stopping me. I am going, and this is what I'm going to do with my life. So I'm so happy to have met her. And she was hanging out with KT from Inside Number 23. KT, you know I love you. We saw each other at Vogue Knitting Live, and I was just so happy to see her again. And we spent a lot of time together, had lunch and like all these different things, and finally got to like sit down, have a conversation, and really, really talk and not just be like running around crazy overwhelmed by yarn fumes. So KT, as usual, you were beautiful and I loved hanging out with you and I look forward to the next time. Kristen from Woolen Vine Yarns and the Yarngasm podcast. That's my girl from Brooklyn. And her husband Dennis, got to hang out with them as well. So I was really happy and excited to see them. I mean, we saw them almost every day, I think. It felt like it, actually. From the plane to the Gillydoo to the festival, it was just Kristen didn't come to the first day of the festival. She came to the second because she was sightseeing on the Friday, and she was like, oh my gosh, this is so overwhelming. And we were like, yesterday was crazier. So but it was all good. We had so much fun. Who else? Oh, duh. Eric from Toronto, Sticks Plus Twine podcast. So me and Eric got to talking, and I am actually going to go to the Toronto Knitters Frolic at the end of April. So I'm going to hang out with Eric a lot more when I go up there. So I cannot wait. We spent a lot of time just walking around, talking, and getting to know people. And it was just cool. I was just so happy to like hang out with him and be in a strange place and know a familiar face. It just felt so nice. And Selma from Two Tangled Skeins, me and Selma, like, we're like this. That was my Kaylee dance partner, and she's the best. We had so much fun. So I'm so happy to see you again, Selma. I gotta make it to Canada one of these days. So I met Nathan Taylor, the sockmatician, and he had this fabulous shawl. It was a double knit shawl with lace, and you can, it's kind of like little windows peeking through, and on the other side you see the other color. That's what it looked like to me. It was just freaking fabulous. I wanted to get a picture of him wearing it, but by the time I thought about it, he was already sitting down and in a long conversation with someone, and I didn't really want to interrupt. But I was talking to him and I was telling him how much I love when he sings and talks about singing, and told him that I like to sing, and we got into that whole spiel. And then I was like, my bad, I didn't introduce myself, I'm just rambling on about singing. And I'm like, my name is Shamika. And he goes, oh, I know who you are. What? Me? Little old me from Brooklyn? Okay. So I was like, alrighty, give him a big hug. We took pictures, and I want to find him wherever he's teaching, and I really want to take a double knit class, because now I am like, my eyes have been opened and I really want that shawl he was wearing. I don't think he's even come up with a pattern for it yet or published it or anything, but if he does, I am so on it. It's not even funny. Like, I'm gonna drop everything and make it. So Nathan, do what you do. I want that beautiful shawl, and I want it in pink and charcoal. He had it in like a blue and an orange. It looked so nice, but yeah, pink and charcoal, that's my thing. So let's do this, Nathan, come on. Let's get this going. So let's see, who else did I meet? Cece Almond from Geeky Girls Knit. I spoke about her before. I feel like we talked for hours. She's just so sweet. I have a lot of her podcasts to catch up on. I watched her recent one and she had me dying laughing on the floor. The way her and her daughter, Dami, the way they interact is just hilarious. Like, I just cannot, like, it just reminds me of me and my mom. So it's just so hilarious. I love their podcast. So I was so happy to meet them. And like I said before, they came out with a book, and I'm going to offer the book as a download, I guess an ebook download, in a forthcoming episode. So I'm really happy, and happy for her generosity, and happy to share her book with you guys when I start sharing everything. So happy to have met her. I also met Lori from the Intuit Knit podcast. I think she's from Toronto. I know she's from Canada. I think it's Toronto. Lori, I look forward to seeing you at the Toronto Knitters Frolic. If you do make it, I want to see you again and hang out and chat. I also met the ladies from the Tipsy Knits podcast. They live in Glasgow. Their names are Pip and Sia Kate. And I just had so much fun talking to them, and they were telling me that they wanted to go to Toronto, asked me if I knew of any yarn shops. So I let them know, you know, my experience there. And I mean, I'm by no means an expert, but I've traveled a few times and I've fallen in love with certain places, and there are still other places I want to check out. So we had a good conversation about that. And of course, I was like, if you're ever in New York and, you know, look me up, I'll take you places. So, you know, that's how I feel about everyone that I've met. I just wanted to continue the whole exchange and just go, let's find a cafe, let's eat, or let's have a drink, whatever, and just knit and just enjoy each other's company. Because, yeah, that was it. Another person, can't forget, John Glenn, Bearded Shield. He lives on the northern tip of Scotland, and I'm just amazed at his lifestyle. Like, I live in a really congested city, and sometimes you just want that peace and quiet. And like, I don't know, he had so much fun stories to tell at the Kaylee, and I was just transfixed. And John, I'm so happy to have met you and met your wife, and it's just so nice. I'm just like overwhelmed at the amount of people I've met now that I can call my friend, and everyone is just all over the world, and it's like we have this one thing that connects us, and it's this string of merino wool, you know, or this string of blue-faced Leicester, or, you know, silk or alpaca. It's just, knitting is just so amazing to connect everyone, and it doesn't matter where you live, what you look like, where you come from. We still all love the same thing, and I'm so happy to be in that mix of the knitting culture that lives that way and appreciates that. So without further ado, let me show you the yarn. I'm going to call this the haul part zero, because this is the craziness before I go to a knitting festival. What I did was not nice. Well, no, I'm not even gonna feel guilty about it. It was nice for me because I enjoyed it. So, when I met up with Grace, actually, okay, I was on virtual knit night and Grace was in Canada, and she just so happened to be staying with Marsha Fairy from the Fairy Little podcast. And Marsha lives right next door to the woman who dyes yarn for Isis Fiber Arts. So there just happened to be this color that I fell in love with. Of course it is pink. It's called, what's the name of it? Dianthus. And okay, I'm gonna try to show you how glorious this yarn is. Do you see the glitters on that? So what I did is, this is so awesome, and it says knitting is sexy. This color I think is amazing. What I did is I basically ordered it while I was on the VCAN. It's a fingering sparkle. Let me give you the real details. It's a fingering sparkle, superwash merino, 75%, 20% nylon, 5% Selena, 438 yards, 400 meters. And, you know, machine wash, lay flat to dry. Yeah, this is just beautiful. So, I ordered it, did not pay shipping. Grace brought it to me from Canada. So sweet. So everything's all fine and dandy, and I'm just hanging out with Grace, and she says, oh, I have a present for you. And I'm like, but you gave me this already. She got me two more skeins. So now, according to Grace, because she was so in love with her featherweight cardigan, she gave me this so that I can make my own featherweight cardigan. Isn't she a sweetheart? She's so sweet. So, there's a featherweight cardigan in the works, or something similar, with the same fingering weight thingamajiggy. So we'll see what this turns into, but I have enough to make a sweater. I am thankful. Thank you so much, Grace. You're so generous, so kind. Really grateful, happy to have this, and I can't stop smiling. I love this color, and I mean, yeah, I can't thank you enough. This is absolutely a beautiful, beautiful gift. I'm truly, truly in love with it. Thank you so, 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 so much. So, I also purchased the Alex Creates ombre yarn from Woolen when I took Grace to Woolen. And basically it's pink, and it's this color is raspberry something. Radioactive grapes. It's a bulky weight and single ply bulky size, 6 to 8 millimeter needles. So it basically goes from light pink to purple. This is the same hat that, why is this escaping me now? It was worn at Vogue Knitting Live. Nancy Ricci from Knitty City. What's wrong with me? Nancy Ricci from Knitty City wore a pussy hat made with this yarn. And I've been interested in it ever since, and I finally got around to buying it. And I'm telling you, I'm crazy, because this is what I buy the day before I fly to a yarn festival. I know, nuts. So, but I couldn't resist. It's absolutely beautiful, and I had to have it. So it's mine now. I work hard for it. I've saved my money. This is my reward for all my hard work. So there you go. Now, lastly, the part zero haul. This is what I received from Haverland Yarns, Carol from Haverland Yarns, she did a Valentine's kit of minis, and she had said, does anyone mind if it comes after Valentine's Day? Because I can re-dye some more. And I had totally missed it. So, of course, I said yes. And it's a bunch of pinks and reds and oranges and purples. And it's falling all over the floor and whatever. But, yeah, this is like right up my alley. And since my beautiful friend Ellie created this pattern that uses scrap yarn, I might have some yarn to do those socks with. So we will get to that. We'll see. We'll see what the specifics are and if I have enough. If not, it'll be a stripy sock, or it could be another pixel rise sock, or any other sock that involves scraps. So we shall see, but this is absolutely beautiful. It's called Cupid's, sorry, that's the yarn falling. Cupid's Mix Franken Socks Kit. So there you go. Yeah, that is the pre-Edinburgh haul, part zero. So now I'm gonna show you day one of the actual Edinburgh haul. Okay. First things first, I walk into the Edinburgh Yarn Festival and the first thing I had to have was the bag, because I knew if I waited, I wouldn't get one. Subsequently, it sold out, and then they had more the next day around 10 o'clock-ish, and then it sold out again. And right now, if you want to go on their website, they are setting up some pre-orders that you can still purchase the bag. So, this is the bag. It is a yarn ball that you can embroider with fingering weight, lace weight, embroidery thread, whatever you like. I really like it. So I bought that, and there's also this mini project bag with the Edinburgh Yarn Festival logo, sheep, ram, cow, whatever. Sheep, ram, I don't know. It's a sheep, right? It's a sheep. Oh, I'm losing it. Yarn fumes hitting me again. So I also got the Wool Tribe magazine, and they have some really nice patterns in here. And I have something that I regretted not buying. This is the Solder Mittens pattern, and I had this in my bag the whole time. I didn't really look through it, so when I saw the mitten kits, I didn't buy it. That is my one regret, but I purchased a lot of other things, so I'm happy with it. So I'm gonna not cry over it. I'll be okay. And the sad thing is, Isolde stood right next to me. She's like, can I help you with anything? And I was just like, I don't know what to buy. Oh my God, what's wrong with me? Anyway, I'll continue with my purchases. And hopefully I can get some Isolde yarn in the future. I don't see that being a problem. I'll find a way. upon walking in, I saw the Shetland Wool Week booth. I took videos, so it'll be in the little montage of video that I have. And this hat is the hat that I was talking about that I said is absolutely beautiful. And you can use basically Shetland yarn to make it. It's a free pattern. They give you all the instructions. They give you different color schemes. It was designed by Gudrun Johnson. I actually got to speak to her. She had designed a cowl that I made eons ago. This was like when she had just started designing patterns, and it was a cowl that you make in two pieces, the Crofter's cowl, that's the name of it. And you Kitchener it together, and that drove me insane because I couldn't really Kitchener that well. But I made it work, and it was a beautiful, beautiful cowl that I made. So upon seeing this and discussing about different types of yarn with Eric, I was able to figure out that I needed to go to Jameson and Smith to get some yarn to make it myself. So let me see if I can grab all the colors here. Am I missing a color? Oh, where'd it go? Here we go. So these are the four colors. Three colors that I'm going to use to make this. You use the main color, you need two skeins, but still. This is what we have as the design color scheme for this hat. So I am really excited about this hat. I don't know when I'm going to cast it on. It's going to have to be soon because, like I said, Ellie, the color bug, has bit me. Thank you. So, fuzz on my lip. Yarn fuzz, of course, because it's Shetland wool right on my face. Anyway, so this is gonna be this hat, and I have to figure out what I'm gonna cast it on, but I'm going to cast it on. So that's another thing. So let's get into my La Bien Amie purchase. Give me 1 second, I have to get more stuff. Can't all fit in one box. So I was showing you before my peanut butter and jelly sock yarn that I got from La Bien Amie, and the Tang sock yarn. It's a little messed up right now. I actually hand wound these because I had forgotten to. They had a setup where you pay 1 pound per skein to wind yarn, and the money goes to a charity. I can't remember the name of it right now, but it has something to do with tea and children. However, I totally missed that. And I didn't realize I needed to wind my yarn until I got to Dublin and didn't have a yarn winder. So I hand wound it in the hotel room. And so this was, like I showed you before, the sock. And I have nowhere to put things. Not only did I get one sock set, I got four actually. So this one, so now what it is it's Blueface Lester Tough Sock Buddies. That's what they call it. So it's 100 grams for the bigger skein and 50 grams for the smaller skein. It's enough to do heels and toes and cuffs, and I think to still have enough left over to do something with it. So this color is Amy's Sweater, and this is the first color I wanted when I saw the La Bien Amie posts on Instagram. Okay, so little backstory. I saw the post on Instagram, and I basically emailed them or Instagram messaged them and said, you are going, there goes my whole budget, basically. There goes my whole budget. So said, so done, because I fell in love with everything. So this color, hey, like I said, Amy's Sweater, and this is called the Hotness. Like, I mean, come on, you gotta have the hotness. Why not, right? So, then I purchased these colors. And this is called, I'm trying to make sure this looks good here. This is called Life Aquatic and Sari. Like sari, like, you know, in India they wear saris. Not sari, like I'm sorry, but sari, S-A-R-I. and this one is Paisley Nouveau and Sari. Again, not sorry. Anyway, don't mind me, I'm being silly. Try to get this to focus in and how beautiful this yarn is. So these are what I fell in love with, what I couldn't decide that I wanted, and I just was like, you know what, I'm just gonna buy them all. Got this beautiful bag. Here we go. So I received this bag, and I also decided to get a few merino singles. Now I have a friend named Lisa who kindly requested a specific color, and the colorway is called, let me see, Peony Graffiti. I'm gonna take pictures and insert because this is just not doing it justice. But I got the Peony Graffiti for Lisa, and I went back the second day to get two more skeins for her because initially I didn't realize she wanted three skeins. So I went and got it for her. I also bought Pinku. It's pink and orange with black speckles. And I also purchased one of these colors for Christy Glass because she is a pink girl like me, and when I saw this, I initially said, that is Christy right there. So, Christy, this one's for you. Here we go. Now I'm learning how to use the camera. See, I told you guys, it's just work in progress. So yeah, this is the beautiful color Pinku from La Vie en Amie. And I got Pop Grunge for me. I cannot wait to turn this into a shawl of some sort. I love the grays and the pops of pink and neon yellow and orange. So, I love that color. Okay, so what else did I get? I got Merino Twist Sock and Pom Pom. This is going to be speckly socks. I'm trying my best to show this. And the last thing from La Vie en Amie is DK Weight Sweaters Quantity of yarn. I am not entirely sure what sweater I'm gonna make yet, but this is Amy's sweater, and it's basically gonna be a gray sweater with speckled bits. So that was my La Vie en Amie haul. I couldn't even carry it. But I'm super excited and super happy for the colors that I've gotten. I'm sorry about this light, guys. I'm just trying to make sure you can see things. Where else did I go? I went to... after La Vie en Amie, I went to the Java Pearl Designs shop. I bought this beautiful bag. Tammy and Cece, coffee, knitting, yummers, and their whole book is about basically being in a coffee shop and knitting. There's a few images of the sock patterns in the back, and there is a shawl pattern and a fingerless mitts pattern. I just want to point out the fingerless mitt pattern here. And I was talking with Cece, and she let me know that I could go and actually buy the actual yarn that was used for the fingerless mitts, which is from Rusty Ferret. And it's just this sock blank. Okay, so I have this sock blank basically. And this is going to be awesome, guys. Just a tie-dyed pink sock blank, but I love it. It's me. It's pink. It's, I don't know if I'm gonna make the mittens yet. I might just do socks, but we'll see. We'll figure this out. And lastly, on day one, I got Volumizer from Loop Yarns. And this is going to make a Viajante shawl wrap thingamajiggy. It takes one skein, and that is all that I need. This is my first skein of Volumizer ever. I have wanted it for so many years. Haven't had the opportunity to buy it, and now it's my little yarn baby. It's really dense and very tightly knit, and it's lace weight, but it feels like a fingering. So I cannot wait to cast this on. I know it's gonna be a big adventure knitting wise, but it's like 300 grams, this thing. This is a decent size ball of yarn here, a skein of yarn. So this is gonna be really, really, really good. So I cannot wait to dig into this. So I'm very, very happy with this purchase. I got it from Loop of London. I just wish one day I could actually go to London and actually go into the shop again. That would be nice. But those were my purchases from day one, and I will continue with the day two purchases. So we had some technical difficulties. The battery died. My haul is too epic for this camera right now. Anyway, I'm going to continue with day two of my stash acquisitions. So the first place that I went to was literally across, before you really get into the marketplace, there were a few areas that were outside of the marketplace that had stalls, and this name of this yarn company is Garthenor. And it is made in Great Britain. It's British wool, and it's organic, and it's has high textile standards. I don't know, hand wash only. It's sheep wool, but it's beautiful. So this is one skein that I got in the natural white colorway. And I also got, okay, this one is the mid-brown colorway. And then I got this marled colorway that is, it's called black brown white marl. Oh, I'll just take this off. You can see like the real deal here. And I also got natural black. This is the color here. So these were the skeins that I bought for Mars from the Brownberry podcast. Hey Brownberry. she really wanted something that was sheepy wool, and she didn't want superwash, and I figured these colors could work together to make a striped something or a colorwork something. So she wanted DK weight, and this is DK weight, and I think this will be perfect for her. So Maris, I'm going to send this to you this week so you can hurry up and get it, and please do not let it sit and just stare at it. It's beautiful yarn, yes, but make it into something fabulous, please. I can't wait to see what you make for this. All right, so this is for you, Maris. And after I went to Garthenor Yarns, I went straight for La Bien Aimée again, because I had to pick up two more skeins of the Peony Graffiti for Lisa. And here they are again. So Amy was so nice, and she gave me this little Notions bag, and it's so cute. So I can't wait to use it. After that, I went to Easy Knits because Carola had told me that they had self-striping yarn, and I found This, the colorway is called Cocktail Hour, and it's a Twinkle Gobstopper. Bam, there we go. And it is absolutely gorgeous. I cannot wait to cast these on. Okay, here we go. I want to cast these on with one of the patterns from Cece Almond's book. So that would be something to look forward to because it's self-striping, and the pattern that I like, which I actually show in the video, is made with self-striping yarn. So it's a perfect match. So that will be coming down the pike. Then after that, I went to Blacker Yarns and I bought wool for a hat to match my shawl. So this is the wool here. The colorway, I'm not sure the name of it. What is it? Stone. And it's just basically a gray hat. I'm gonna hold it double. And this is fingering weight. Four ply. I'm going to hold it double and make a worsted weight hat out of it. Hopefully it'll cover all my curls. We'll see. And last but not least, I went to, getting a line down here. I went to, what's the name of this place again? Laxton's Limited, and I bought 7 skeins of Falkland Merino Fine Merino Sparkle DK yarn. So initially, I wanted to make the Aspen Cardigan by Michelle Wong, from the Capsule Collection, the Brooklyn Tweed Capsule. Sorry, yarn falling. So I wanted to make the Aspen Cardigan, and this yarn was wholesale priced. So I figured, ooh, I could buy a wholesale set of yarn and have enough, because I need 20 skeins of Brooklyn Tweed yarn for the actual pattern. But when I went, everything was sold out, so this is what they had left, and I was like, okay, I'll just make another DK weight something or the other. I'm not sure what it's gonna be yet. I can dye this if I want to. That's another rabbit hole. We'll see if I get to that. So yeah, I have this, and I'm gonna make something beautiful with it. It's really soft, it's sparkly, it's right up my alley. I just need to make sure I decide what color I want and decide on the sweater. I think once I find the sweater, the color will come. So look forward to that. And we'll see, you know, where that adventure takes me. So while we were in Dublin, we headed to This Is Knit to check out the yarn shop. It was actually walking distance from our hotel. We stayed close to the city center in Dublin, I think. We were like just in the middle of town. So we were actually close to everything. So we just Googled it and we found This Is Knit, and we said, oh, let's see what an Irish yarn shop looks like. And it was absolutely beautiful. It is run by Jenny and Jackie, a mother and daughter team, and they did a fabulous job of the store. I have video, you will see it. This is the bag that I bought. It's so pretty. And when I walked in, I perused, I looked around, and I found that they actually have their own, they actually have their own yarn, Townhouse Yarns. So you can find them on Instagram as Townhouse Yarn. They were actually at Edinburgh Yarn Festival, but I somehow missed them because they were in someone else's booth, I think. So, but it's totally okay because I was able to see them in Ireland. So Jenny hand dyes all the yarn. First thing I saw was this speckle. It's a superwash merino cashmere nylon. It's called Clarendon Sock, which is funny because there's Clarendon Road somewhere near my house. Anyway, it's called Cauldron Bubble. And let me get out of the way of the camera. It is just speckly purples and teals. Absolutely gorgeous. So that was the first thing that I was drawn to. And then I said, well, I am in Ireland. I must have some Donegal tweed because Donegal, Ireland, hello, I needed to have some. And I found this colorway, and I kind of butchered this skein because it kind of fell apart when I was bringing it home. So I tried to put it back together, and it's not as beautiful as they had it initially. But this is called Camden Tweed, and the colorway is Embers, and I wanted something pinkish. They didn't have pink, but this was close enough. And I'll give you a, if I can zoom in on the label here. And the majority of their colorways are named after things that are close to them geographically. So this is called Embers. We have another one. No, is it something that's close to them geographically? I can't remember. Okay, I'm gonna. So I found another color called Emerald Isle. And I mean, Ireland, it's green. St. Patrick's Day, this is just absolutely beautiful. I don't think this lighting is giving it justice. It's more Kelly green than it's showing here. It's looking more turquoise in the screen. But, and then we also have this colorway called Burin. And I think this is absolutely beautiful. And I think that this should be part of a giveaway. So I am going to have something in the Ravelry group for this yarn to be given away. And I'm also adding a pair of Knit Pro Zings, 2.25 millimeters in 80 centimeters, which is I think 32 inches. And you can magic loop with that. So this is going to be prize pack giveaway for one of my lovely subscribers, listeners, somebody out there. Please join the Ravelry group. And once you join the Ravelry group, you will get all the information you need about giveaways and prizes and everything alike. So while we're on the topic of zings, I found the Zing interchangeable pack. I'm so excited. So I wanted to try these for a long time. They don't have this in the States, so I'm so happy I found it. This is mine. I'm so excited. The next thing I cast on will be with this. And I also got one last thing from there, which is stamps. Now, I'm not really totally into stamping, but this will make me fall down that rabbit hole. So yeah, I am ready. And this is a little black stamp pad in here, but I already have pink and purple ink. So this is just awesome. Made by me, handmade, made with love. And it has a sewing thing. It has a little knitting basket, and then it has a ball of yarn. It's absolutely gorgeous. And I cannot wait to start using it. So what else do I have to say? That is the haul, all of the haul. I do want to say that, like I said, I'm going to cast on my next item with this, something from this pack. Cast on news. So I am going to talk about the next thing that I have coming down the pike that I'm going to cast on. I have decided to do a knit along with Carola of the What Makes My Soul Sing podcast. And we have decided to do the Find Your Fade shawl. She has her lineup of colors already. I have my lineup of colors already. Now, I know this is last minute because I want us to start April 1st, which is this coming Saturday. And it's okay. If you can't start it this soon, it is all right, because it's not going to end until August 31st. So it's going to be a fade from spring into summer knit along. So I encourage you, if you would like to join, check out the Ravelry group. I'm going to put in a chatter thread and an FO thread, and we can start chit-chatting about the plans that we have for our fades. If you remember the last episode, I showed all my fade colors. I'm going to have them shown again in the Ravelry group. So basically, we didn't want to make it something that was too short that you couldn't obtain. And we wanted to give you time to just to get it done. If you want to do one, if you want to do two, if you want to do three. I've seen people who just can't choose colors. So they've come up with many different spectrums that they want to incorporate. So I encourage you to join us, and there will be prizes. I'm doing my whole Fade in Hedgehog, so the prize will definitely be a skein of hedgehog yarn. What color, I'm not sure at the moment, but that will hit me when I get to the store and actually buy it. So I look forward to hearing from you if you want to join in on the knit along. There are also a few other Find Your Fade knit alongs going on. And you know, it's a big shawl. I have a feeling that some people may not have finished. Feel free to join. If you have less than 50% of your shawl complete and you want to join with a work in progress, by all means, feel free to join. You can double dip in other knit alongs if you want to. It's very, we're not like being super, super stressful about rules. We just want you to join, have a good time, get those colors going, see the beauty of the whole project, and you have until the end of summer to finish it. Fading from spring into summer. I am going to post the Instagram hashtag here, and you can start tagging things. I'm gonna post some things on Instagram as well, and that will be just, I can't wait. I cannot wait to cast on this new project. I know I have all these products on the needles, but that is just one of the things that I've been like wanting to cast on, and I have been holding back because I wanted to wait for this knit along. So yeah, there you go. That is the next thing down the pike for me. Secondly, Eric Lutz is having a knit along for his, he's calling it A Tweed Grows in Brooklyn. So it's basically Brooklyn tweed knit along. If you use a Brooklyn tweed pattern, you get one entry. If you use a Brooklyn tweed pattern alone, if you use a Brooklyn tweed pattern and a Brooklyn tweed project, you get two entries. If you use a Brooklyn tweed pattern project and a pattern yarn and a Michelle Wong designed Brooklyn tweed pattern, you get three entries into it, and the winning prize is the assigned book of Michelle Wong's capsule collection. I already have one, so if I happen to win it, I will most likely donate it to another winner or pass it along to the next winner. I have to let Eric know that, but I actually intend on having two projects. The first one would be my permafrost shawl that I didn't finish last time. And the second, I really want to make the Aspen cardigan. I am in love. It's not even a cardigan, it's a robe. I'm in love with this. So I actually spoke to Jared Flood. Me and Eric talked to him about this knit along, and he is super excited about it. And I was like, oh my God, what am I gonna do? I can't lug 20 skeins of this yarn all the way back to New York. And he goes, oh, here's a coupon code. I was like, so the hardest part now is picking a color. I think I found the color I want. You will see it in the video that I took, because I touched it and I fell in love with it. And I don't think I can be really swayed, but who knows. I spoke to Michelle herself, and she said, I want to see that in hot pink. But the color is in hot pink, but we'll see. I think she'll be happy with any color that I do, because I mean, I love cables. I love her design style. And she told me that I execute the cables really well, so woohoo, I'm happy with that. So yeah, it's just when I get her patterns, I take them very seriously, and I don't want to make a mistake. And I take my time, I read the pattern, and I just follow along. It can be daunting because it's so much, but once you get the pattern repeats down, it's kind of, it flows. So I love her design style. I love her aesthetic. And I definitely want to cast that on, along with my Find Your Fade shawl for April. Those will be my cast-ons. So there you have it. That is all that I have to share from Edinburgh Yarn Festival and everything that has happened before and after and has gone through my brain surrounding this wonderful yarn adventure.
Cheers.
So what are you knitting? What are you doing?
I am knitting the Audrey 2 cardigan. Hopefully you'll see me in it on Sunday.
So okay.
I'm gonna get some Shamika vitamins and be up all night. So this will be done for Sunday.
All right, so we're gonna do this. We will have this thing done.
Okay.
Hi, Grace.
Hi, how are you?
I'm good.
I just finished my sweater. Do you like it?
It is absolutely beautiful. And you gotta show off your nails. Match, so awesome.
And my earring, hang on, it all matches, right?
Yes.
Don't go
yes.
too close.
Lovely.
I've got no makeup on, so.
No, no worries, you're beautiful.
I'm all styled now, thanks to Shamika.
Aww.
Shamika's mommy.
Aww.
And I'm fed now as well.
Lovely.
So we're having a great time in Edinburgh.
Yes, we are. I gotta kind of do the thing.
It's been such a long journey.
We're here now and we're really excited. I don't know what I'm gonna buy tomorrow. I think I'm gonna buy everything.
But just don't limit yourself.
No. I may have to rob a bank, but I won't say which one.
Because
I need more money to buy more yarn.
I'm just loving meeting everybody with their faces.
Yeah, seeing everybody
and
being
alive and giving them hugs.
Because like 2 months ago I didn't know you.
I know.
Because I have this badge, so I get to get in early. So I'm walking in now. Good morning. Oh, wow. I can't video this. This is so nice. It's empty this morning. I've got to get the bag. Good morning. I'm recording for my podcast. I've got to get one of these bags.
It's a 6 and 8.
Okay. And I want to get a wool tribe as well. I've got to get it all. All right. We got tin can knits. Lovely, beautiful yarn kits from Little Heirloom. All these wonderful shawls. We just got here. This is just lovely. Oh, and here we go. Here is the Brooklyn Tweed Wall of Greatness from Brooklyn. Duh. Seriously. The Arbor.
have a lot of Arbor. I want shelter. Oh, I haven't tried Quarry yet. This is so cool to see this here.
Books here and then some of the Arbor patterns.
I want this color.
Just in case. And I have a look at the
okay, yeah, great.
I want this color.
Yeah.
So that's the fourth.
I think that's what I'm in love with. But I don't know. There's so many other nice colors. So I have a pattern in mind that I want to make. It's going to take 20 skeins.
20.
Yeah, it's a long robe with all cables and pockets. It's beautiful.
It's
in the capsule collection.
I think it's 50 grams, isn't it? It's not so much on the skein.
Yeah. Wow. It's a lot of ends to weave in.
and a lot of money to pay.
Yeah,
a lot of
that too.
To pay.
Just cut me a coupon so that I can get my yarn, and I won't have to bring it on the plane. I can just order it when I get back to the States. So I'm really excited. So expect to see that coming down the pipe. You can get wine. You can get food. This is lovely. We won't have to starve to death. Let's go inside, shall we? This is the beginning before it gets crazy. I haven't quite seen anybody I really know yet. But I know that's going to change in a few minutes. I need to find... I don't even know where I'm going. I'm just walking around aimlessly. Got Kate Davies designs here. Ooh. Beautiful. These things are. These lovely tables.
I have
looked at
the
this is where I want to start. Again, I mean? May? I think I need to buy something before like it's all gone. It's so pretty. Uh-oh, I might learn how to spin. It might be a problem. It might be a really big problem. Kristen Valentine, you got me started on this. But that's not on me. Look at this yarn.
Okay, tell me which colors you want to go to grab them. Back
over here. On the very left.
The special one? Okay.
I want that.
Good plan.
Hi! Farrell! I'm Shamika. How are you?
Nice to meet you.
Hi, Katie. How are you?
I'm good. How are you?
Oh, you were there last night, weren't you?
Yes, but yeah, I didn't recognize you because you changed your hair. It looks lovely.
Turquoise.
I like it. I'm recording, by the way, still.
Shamika is like the best person in the world.
Oh, thank you.
She's so stylish. She's wearing a void shield in my favorite color, which I'm sure she made for me as a gift. She says it's not for me, but I think that she's just playing hard to get. Yeah.
Yay, Shamika! Okay, so I just ran into Katie and Vero from Intent Number 23 in Among the Lanes, and the camera shook a little bit when I was giving out some hugs. So I'm here, back again. I am at La Pien Ami, and I'm just going to show you this gorgeous, gorgeous, gorgeous yarn. Oh.
Jesus.
I really, really want this.
So
I'm definitely getting this one. And look at this one. Oh, this is just calling my name. Absolutely beautiful. Beautiful colors. There's another one that I want. Look at that. I want a sweater out of this. Can I have a sweater out of this? I don't even know what sweater I want. I just want a sweater out of this. Absolutely gorgeous. Let's come over here. On the wall, we've got all the merino singles. Look at that color over there, pink. With a little flexible. Are you ready? Black. I don't know what I want. Oh my god, I need to buy something like right now. This is what I want a sweater of. Look at these beautiful shawls. This is just absolutely gorgeous. This is my color here, like, seriously. And then I'm looking for... I don't even know. I don't even know where to begin. The fact that we're getting more is very helpful.
They will be the same dialogue if I can.
I can make socks out of this.
Sorry, I'm just right by your leg.
Oh, go right ahead. I can move over for you. Don't let me get in your way. Okay, it's time for me to do some damage. I will show you everything that I buy. Okay. Hopefully we are in frame.
Hopefully. Hi.
Introduce yourself, please.
Oh yes, I'm Becky. I have podcast too. String It Together.
Nice. And I'm Mika Mika, of course, from Midnight with Mika Mika. And we also have
Hannah from the Corner of Craft and the Crafty Chat podcast.
Lovely. Yay. I met these ladies, they're all the way from Germany in Edinburgh, and I'm all the way from Brooklyn, New York, and this is so amazing that we can just come together one place and go crazy over the yarn fields.
Yes.
How are you ladies enjoying it today?
It's a little crazy.
Overwhelming.
Yes, I
want
to buy everything.
I want to buy.
Yeah.
Which means I'm either going to buy nothing or everything. It's going to be one of two ways.
I think everything is the better choice.
Everything is the better choice.
Let's do it.
Alrighty. So, like I like to say, embellish your knitting, embellish your life.
Yes, indeed. Amen.
Amen. Hi, I'm here with Karen from Do You Knit.
Hi, everybody.
What's your favorite color, Karen?
Pink.
Can you tell?
Pink.
This is my pink sister right here. Love her. So how are you enjoying Edinburgh Yarn Festival?
Fun. Only got to do one booth. It's a little early yet.
Mm-hmm.
But I'm on it because I carry hand-dyed yarns from all over the world.
Yes.
And I'll be shopping for the store.
Wonderful. So I will be really happy to get everything that I can get here in New Jersey.
Great. I'm going to get enjoying the
shape.
Bye-bye.
I just went crazy in La Vianney. First 5 minutes I'm here, I just spent, I'm not even going to say how much I spent. I bought sweater quantities, I bought sock quantities, more than like 4 pairs of socks and some merino singles. They're beautiful colors. I'm so excited and I don't regret it at all because I work hard and it's time to play hard. So let me walk around some more and show you guys more of Edinburgh Yarn Festival. Hello!
Hiya!
This is
Cece of Java Pearl Designs and the Geeky Girls Knit Podcast.
And I'm so excited to meet her here at Edinburgh Yarn Festival.
That's right.
Do you see, we're like pink sisters again.
Yay.
I keep finding people with pink. I love it.
Pink for the win.
I love the hair.
Thank you. It's been lovely to meet you.
Oh, lovely to meet you as well.
Fabulous.
Tell me about your new book. Because I see some sock patterns in there that
I love. It is. So it's a collection of 7 patterns, a wrap, 5 sock patterns, and a fingerless mitts pattern all inspired by coffee.
Oh my god. Cannot live without their coffee.
I know.
I gotta have it every morning.
I know.
I need like an IV drip with
seriously.
Coffee.
Yeah. Seriously. I constantly say from Gilmore Girls, coffee and an IV stat.
Yes.
That's it. That's what we need.
Exactly. was a pleasure.
Thank you. Lovely to meet you. Thank you. Lovely to meet you.
Definitely getting that book.
All right.
All right. I'll let you guys, I'll give you guys an exclusive.
All right.
Ready.
Bye.
Bye-bye. I am here at Cece Almond's shop right now, and she has a new book out. And what I, this is my favorite pattern right here, and it is called Chai Latte. And if you see, basically what you do is you change the pattern for every stripe of the sock. So this can work for any self-striping socks. You guys know I love self-striping. You know I'm doing this self-striping thing, 12 socks this year for Bull and Vine's knit along, the box of socks and decal. So this is actually gonna be one of the socks that I'm gonna make. And I'm loving it. So you guys should check it out. I bought the book, so I will let you know all about it.
Okay, so here we are at Jajard Arbenz's site, booth. Look at all these beautiful colors. Look at this. Alpaca. We've got the fleece. This looks nice. Fibers. We have here blue BFL and Westerdale. It feels good. It feels sheepy but still soft. I love this color.
Because you guys know the pink. You know the pink.
So look at this wall of colors. Knit by numbers. I think they're 50 gram balls. You buy 10, you get one free. I could totally do color work something with this. So beautiful. I have to decide what I want. Totally confused. I don't know what to get. I really don't know what to get.
Hi.
That's the favorite little gray girl.
They have a pink sock blank that I want. That's all I'm saying. A pink sock blank.
It's over there.
I really want it badly. Let's see how it looks up close. I am getting my sock blank and a really, really nice project bag to put my sweater in. It is absolutely gorgeous. This is Rusty Ferret, Little Gray Girl. I'm getting one of each. So, I'll show you what's being run up in a minute.
What do we have here?
Large heart.
So pretty.
I've taken the paper out.
All we've got to do is put a medium heart on
it. It's all mine!
Love the fact it matches so beautifully.
Thank you so much!
22 for the bag.
Alrighty. Okay, so we are at the Rusty Ferret. I just purchased that pink sock length over there that I fell in love with, and I'm just showing all the rest of the yarn here. So,
how pretty this is. I might just buy this one as well. When it
works so much. Sorry, Anthony. There we go. Thank you. Sorry,
I could get to squeeze in and get a little picture of the yarn. Look at this one. Look at this one.
English accent and being here, there are
video now, so.
Yay!
She can! This lovely lady here has helped me so much.
What are we talking about?
We're in the podcasting lounge.
We're in the podcasting lounge.
And it's very hot. Do you see me sweating? It's crazy.
I feel like
I'm at Bikram Yoga right now. Experience. I've watched her podcast and her basically her recap of last year's Edinburgh Yarn Festival. And like 2 seconds into it, I'm like, I want to go. I'm going to go. I'm going to Scotland. Forget
she
everything
came from
else.
Brooklyn. How
I'm
cool
going
is
to Scotland.
That?
So I'm so excited to meet you.
So happy to be here.
So how are you enjoying the festival?
Oh, it's so, so much fun. I there's something truly amazing about hanging out with a community of knitters. Like, first thing I did was just kind of start petting her sweater. Like, I must know everything about it right now. It's just, everyone is a little bit like that. Everyone's
yes,
a little bit
yes.
high on yarn fumes.
Exactly,
as you can
tell. Yes.
But
it's making me sweat. You see this? It's hot in here. It's getting hot in here.
Hot. Like, even at 9 a.m. it was already a little
yeah.
bit toasty.
Yeah.
So,
yeah, and the line out the door was crazy, but we have these. So we got an early. That's really nice. But nice and not nice because, like, my whole budget was gone in 5 minutes. But it's all good.
Yeah.
It's all good because we love it all.
So much yeah. nice stuff. So yeah. many. I think Edinburgh Yarn Festival is probably, out of any event I've ever attended, the one that's got just the highest quality stalls.
Yes.
Just every single
yes.
one is just perfect.
Yes.
Too perfect. Dangerously perfect.
Yes. So, what is the first thing you're going to knit? Do you know?
Well, I have I might have bought a sweater quantity of Flavien MA in DK.
So did I! Oh my god!
Stash comparison.
Yes, hold on.
Is a peachier,
yes,
but
yes.
very similar kind of level of shade.
Yes.
Yes.
And so what are you going to make?
I don't know.
I
it's
going
to be cardigan. Cardigan for sure,
I'm
because
the
like
same thing.
I don't do very well with closed sweaters.
Yeah.
I get too
yeah.
hot.
Because we get too hot.
Yes.
Yeah.
So maybe we'll have to like
maybe we'll do another one or something. Yeah. That'll work. Because I don't have a pattern in mind yet.
Neither do I. But Ravelry is magical for
yes,
that.
Yes, it is. Yes, it is. And we can make the link across the pond.
Absolutely.
That'll be awesome.
Excellent.
Okay.
Yeah, looking forward to seeing what you make out
oh, yes.
of
this beautiful yarn. Yeah. Good? Okay. So thank you so much for checking us out, and see you soon. Hello, everyone. This is day 2 of Edinburgh Yarn Festival. I am here pretty early. It's about 9 a.m., and so the place is actually very quiet. Surprisingly, yesterday was a madhouse. So anyway, I'm going to head over there to Gardiner Yarns and see if I can get some real woolly wool. So let's go check it out. I am here at the Gardiner Yarns booth and everything is absolutely gorgeous. If you want the best in undyed wool, check this out behind me. I mean, look at these yarns. So this is my favorite here, this or organic marled yarn here. It's absolutely gorgeous. And they've got all the weights, from lace weight down to chunky. Absolutely beautiful. It's all organic. It's 100% certified. Absolutely gorgeous colors. You can't go wrong with this. You don't have to worry about any allergies to dyes or anything. It's just beautiful sheepy wooliness. So I've just bought 4 skeins to send to a friend, and I hope she loves it. This is my first purchase of the day, and I've had some time to think about my yarn purchases, and this is just one of those things that you just have to have in your stash. Let's take another video here. This is my favorite section right here. Day 2, still early. Look at how empty it is in here. This was a mad rush yesterday, so we just have some time to think
clearly and decide what we really want. And not go crazy like I did yesterday. So, just got some. I am looking for some sock yarn that is. What am I looking for? Sock yarn that is self-striping. Haven't quite found it yet. Ooh, look at this. This color is spectacular. Yeah, how are you? Beautiful, beautiful colors. Oh my gosh.
Gotta have some gingerbread.
Oh yes. Oh, lovely.
And some yarn from Poland.
Of course.
New one.
Sure, I do. You know what happens
at the festival?
I like these here.
Yeah, you buy them. And you knit.
And you knit something
them.
Beautiful.
You don't need to knit.
It's beautiful. Love them. You can just squish it.
Yeah.
So pretty. This is what I'm in love with right here. I found myself striping. So just take a quick look at, sorry, these colors. Splatters of everything. What I love are these gradient sets down here, especially this one. Oh, it's so beautiful. I don't even know where to start. I'm like transfixing a color trance right now.
Okay, done.